Hello, Jamalf here, and welcome back to Let's Play XCOM 2, where we have a mission. We need to rescue Marpo's ear, or actually by getting him as a reward from my character pool. We need to protect the device. I haven't had that kind of mission before. It's easy. We have two new soldiers here. We have Mr. Ord, as in Christopher Ord. Do go watch his XCOM Let's Play if you haven't yet, and also go watch Marpo's ears Let's Play. If you want to see someone who's actually good at the game, go watch Marpo's ear. And Christopher Ord has done an excellent job as well. And then we have the daughter of Sofia Rajnovolkova from the original series. Character I created to the character pool as my first character there, kind of with the real backstory. So she's here. Sofia just had her before the original war 20 years ago, and now she's here following her mother's footsteps, hopefully with better results. Well, maybe that's up to me. So let's go and protect the device, whatever that means. I absolutely love the character pool. I can't wait to fill it completely for put 100 soldiers there for the, or 100 characters there for the pool, and then no need for renaming or anything like that.
Data critical to the aliens' latest project from the Advent Network using something they rigged up in this area. As far as we can tell, the aliens have figured out what's going on and they're sending reinforcements in to destroy the device. We're moving in to secure the area and protect the device before they manage to take it out.
Mr. Ord and Irina, they are chilling out. Ready for the mission. Okay, so I guess this is kind of, we will be standing our ground, protecting the device, and the aliens will be coming for us. I think this is the team that can do it.
Forces are already moving to destroy the data tap installed nearby. We need to lock down the area and secure the device at all costs.
Okay. I thought that the device would be like here and we would have waves of enemies coming at us. But as it is, it's more of a traditional mission, but we need to protect it, not destroy it. Right.
Ordine ricevuto, mi muovo.
For some reason, there is no Russian language back in the game. I found that very odd. No pun intended, Mr. Ord.
Position confirmed. Rücke aus.
Actually, let's go and see what is up ahead.
I'm all over it.
Nothing we can see. Okay, there's a tower there. Let's go to the other side of the boss. High ground there. From there I could see... If I were to destroy this, it has a lot of hit points, but I guess if the enemy gets there and they will start shooting at it, I will have to rush here. I don't have a time limit, but that might be an even tougher time limit than actual time limit. You know?
Mi avvicino alle coordinate.
On my way.
I'm afraid of stepping there just in case it's... Oh, but we are in concealment, right? Alright, so they are... Right. Oh no, they are already firing at it. What the hell? Wow! So we are in concealment, but they are already firing at it. Okay, let's stay in concealment. We need to rush towards that... towards that thing.
camino.
I forgot that we are in concealment here.
Ordini confermati. Mi muovo.
So yeah, no Russian language back, so I'm using the Italian instead for Irina. Okay, there's a house there, so we should be safe there.
Ordenes confirmadas. En marcha.
Rushing with the sniper, well, it is what it is. Okay, if they come forward, they will see us if I don't get into cover. That would be a good spot. I might need to ambush these guys, so let's go there. And will you spot me from here? No, you won't. So let's go there. Sadly, I think you need to be there, because if I go here and they come forward, you will be spotted and out in the open, and they might actually shoot at you. Hello. Don't shoot. Don't shoot. Don't shoot. Now that's how you start your career in XCOM, Irina. That's how you start your career. Oh no. Oh no, 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 no. Well, as long as they are coming to us, they are not firing at the device. Okay, so now what do we do? We'll probably throw a grenade here. And then be ready to shoot next turn. Do we just throw the grenade from here, actually? Take their covers out, damage them. Or are they just... Oh, can the heavy do it? Because these grenades, yeah, they have a better. Okay, so I will go here to good cover. Launch grenade. That's the first thing I do. And then. Then we will. We have one grenade to be thrown from here. Can't for sure. Alright, from this side you actually still have a. I think it's best for me to take boss here and shoot that guy with the pistol.
Bien, me muevo al objetivo.
Because that will be a. Very good odds. And
enemigo abatido.
Of course the Viper has to die. We can heal from here, so I think I'm coming to this car. We don't have a combat protocol with you, we do have a grenade. We have a grenade in here as well. I don't think I can get both of them, so let's get to cover here. Yeah, I can't damage them both. 70% on that one, then we do have a grenade. I can't come in with you and have a good shot, so I think I will just run to good cover anyway. Two grenades would guarantee the kill on the Viper. I think I will take your shot first, because if it crits, it can actually kill it. But you don't even hit. I think we might be in a little bit of a trouble here. Now I might as well shoot, because there's still a chance to kill it. And a grenade wouldn't do any more, so Mr. Ord, I'm counting on you. That's not killing it. Now we, for the first time, get to see what this Viper actually does. And I'm not too happy that's going to happen, because one of our soldiers might be dead here. Mm-hmm.
Vale, esto va mal.
Yeah. Ooh, well, we were in full cover, so that's good. Wow. Okay, we need to get our sniper away from that bound. Another 70% shot. I guess grenade is out of the question now. And we might want to save this one because we might want to heal. Do I come closer? Yes, I do, even if it's health cover. And even if it means getting more enemies to this fight, 74%. And then we could grenade that guy.
Position confirmed.
But the Viper has to die, of course, first. 76. We have a grenade from here as well. I can damage them. Without. At least that seems that will damage, not damage boss. There's a warning for friendly fire, right? That's pretty precision. Grenade, if it actually works. So now a grenade can kill them both, but the normal grenade doesn't have the coverage. So another 76% shot. 2 damage. It actually dodged it, but that was enough. Will boss stay there, or can I move boss? Ah, okay, he has his move. Good. Because then you can do this. And then probably want to heal you. There are no active enemies at the moment, so it doesn't matter if I stay out in the open. I still want to move forward because we have a device to protect. So a Gremlin heal. Actually, do I need to? Do I want to save my heal? Ooh, there's a door there that actually might reveal something. If I go to it next turn.
Sono in movimento.
There seems to be one. Maybe that's I think that's a sectoid, because that seems like the sectoid's weapon. You know what? Why don't you go up there?
Ordini confermati, mi muovo. Vediamo l'obiettivo.
Get 4.
Menace 1-5, we've got a line on the target. Move to protect that gear at all costs.
I will. Not sure if I want to spot the sectoid yet. There's still plenty of hit points on it. Is this door is open, right? Yes. I used all my grenades here.
Schon unterwegs.
I guess I will go here and see what the enemy is, because then they might actually shoot me instead of the device. And if I take good cover here, I should be okay. And that was a... What the hell did you do? Oh right, you went behind the fireplace. Can you actually... Oh, wow, that's good. That is good, because then I can go here, throw a grenade. Fire. Even you have a grenade. Can't see you do that, so I wonder, I'm not sure if this fireplace will actually go away. Let's throw a grenade anyway. Did. So it's in 87%, 40% critical. Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
Fantastic job. And we have something I will probably do with the Overwatch here. We'll probably have a reanimation coming here.
Help! Help! Someone help!
Ooh, don't shoot us! Okay, hunker down, that's okay. I wonder if that was a mind control attempt. Was that a mind control attempt, or was that actually a... Well, you can see him. 45% are nice. I don't have a good shot from here. To, I'll probably run... Well, I can drop down next time. I don't think there are more enemies here. No, but if I go here, I will have a shot. But does that matter? Because it is behind a tree. I don't think I can destroy that. So I'm thinking that will I go here and flank next turn? Or do I go somewhere I can take a shot this turn to assist? And there are really not any good spots. But how? So do I actually see through this gap here on the top floor? I think that's it. I see it from here. Percenter. I don't think I can kill it. That's on fire, it might even collapse. I don't think the sectoid will see me if I go here. I think you will overwatch anyway. We will have this height advantage shot here. Nice! Free damage through full cover. 45% there. I take that.
I'm running low on ammo.
Can we move forward and throw a grenade? Not a bad option.
Bien.
I should have done that. I should have done that first. I messed up. It was stupid of me. Now there's no point in it. It's good if it stays there. What flank? Now this is reanimation. Reanimation is fine because it basically wastes a turn. Because the zombie doesn't move right away. So, do we get more experience if we actually kill the zombie? Not sure. I will take a shot at the zombie through the floor.
Bin auf dem Weg!
With you. I think we will throw a grenade. Can I do it in a way that it would damage you all? No. Well, let's at least make sure we kill the sectoid, so let's go with the grenade there. Then we can throw a grenade with Irina if all the other shots fail. So let's try to maximize the experience, not sure if it actually is the case. Well, at least it will spread the kills. If we get like a... Even if... I'm not sure if the zombie actually counts as one, because you already have... Wait. I was supposed to save Irina for the grenade, but maybe 92% was enough.
Status confirmed. All hostiles are down and the area is secure. Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
So we took two points of damage being bound by the Viper. But apart from that, that went really well. Shots hit. Irina dealt more damage. Maybe I was preferring Irina the most with my attacks, but that is part of the story, and she's really happy about it too, how that went. Let's see what her class is. It would be suitable if she was Ranger, in a way, Assault. I didn't want to go to the Guerrilla Tactics School and train her to.
I wondered how the new gear would hold up, Commander. Looks to me like it's working out just fine.
Alright, wounded. Not gravely wounded, so that's good. Let's this time get the higher ranked guys promoted first. So we will definitely go for revival with Bruno here. He's our medical specialist. Then we have new options for the grenadier, so suppression or demolition. Unleash a volley of bullets at your target's cover, significantly damaging or destroying it. Deals no damage. So suppression or destroying cover. Granting reaction fire against, imposing 50% penalty to target's aim. I really like demolition, because usually I use the grenades, kind of, well, not only damage, but usually more importantly to remove cover. Then again, suppression kind of goes well with, kind of, as a defensive. You at least, they have that minus 50 aim, and if they happen to move, you have a shot, so I will go with suppression on Neil, kind of going on the right side, if you will. And for boss, I think we will go for the more traditional sniper, so long watch, can overwatch from squad side. We already have a gunslinger sniper on our squad. And then, Irina. XCOM, I love you. Actually, I don't remember if I set Irina to be a ranger in the... Ranger in the character pool, but if I didn't... Yeah, fantastic. Just the right class. And we have another sniper and Mr. Odd. So plenty of snipers, probably going for the gunslinger route. We have one kind of sniper, and then rest of them will be in the line of fire with their pistols. Got one additional expanded
you
magazine.
You and your crew have dealt another serious blow to the aliens' efforts today, Commander.
And since we got Marbo's here, we have fourth sniper. So actually, I will start training, forcing the other rookies to be some other class. We have plenty of snipers now. So let's go to the actually see the soldiers. So we have a couple of rookies there, including Demon, who won't be snipers in this case. And then we can level up. We can level up Marbo Zero, so he will probably be then a traditional sniper. I don't know. How will I do this? Maybe I will have another one with going the sergeant way. So let's take the long watch. And then let's go and get our rookies trained, so let me see. We have three grenadiers, we have three rangers, four sharpshooters. I probably want more specialists, so I have a backup medic. So this soldier will actually be renamed. I will do that between the videos. I think I want a specialist, so 5 days. And Demon. I always want to have a grenadiers there. Rangers, I can probably just use one. I don't know, maybe Demon would be nice as a Phantom Ranger. And turn Irina into a Blade Master. So then I would have two of each. Ah, right, I can only train one at a time. Fair enough. What I was doing before all this happened. Oh, reward engineer, yes.
Avenger plotting
priority, priority, priority. Go, go, go. I was about to open this area here to us, but getting an engineer, not going to pass on that chance. I don't know, how long can I postpone the black sites? Oh no, Avatar Project gets one block, so it's halfway.
Commander, if we want to set back the aliens' work on the Avatar Project, we should hit one of their facilities as soon as possible.
I'm going. I'm heading that way. Oh crap, even more?
Commander, the aliens continue to make progress on the Avatar Project. If we're going to slow them down, we'll need to move fast.
I think I need to go to the Black Site mission. I don't know, does the Black Site mission even reset this? Retaliation is incoming as well. Good. Now let's put the demon there. As a ranger. And let's continue scanning this one. Acid grenade. Okay, excellent. Sounds good. I didn't even check what the gas grenade does and didn't take it. Maybe I should have at least taken a look, but I just didn't like the gas grenades in the first game. Alright, excellent. We have an engineer. And then we can go back into making contacts. Maybe after this I will go do the black sites. No, but wait, I was building the radio relay.
For the Arctic territories.
So that first. That's what I was doing. We will have to rush to the site. If the black site doesn't decrease the Avatar process, I will have to rush to the Western Europe. Like, fast. Okay. So now, supplies have been decreased for the next one. Okay, we have alien machinery. decreased, so I'm thinking about this Advanced Warfare Center, because this means I can get some bonuses when I level up, so the earlier I build this, the better. And I probably need the resistance comms as well. Engineers can be staffed, creating unique gremlin drones. Can't be sent to staff any. Oh, so workshop in the middle would be really good, because it could assist four projects. Lab. Assisting in research, okay. But I think I want this Advanced Warfare Center first.
Advanced matter has pushed our current power systems to the limit. We don't have any capacity to spare, which means we can't expand our facilities further.
Okay. So we'll probably put one here. Maybe if I put one here, then I could build a workshop and I could staff these with it. Then again, that would like waste one slot. If I build a workshop here, it would power these ones. Maybe I will need to clear this one. Clear this one as fast as possible for the supplies, and also make a room for the power. Yeah, actually, workshop here wouldn't do much because because I don't think you can staff the Guerrilla Tactics School. Okay, there are things here I need to take into account when building this base that I should have looked at the workshop description, so I would have known. But it is what it is. But I think I will build power here. Maybe power here. Not sure if engineers do anything in the warfare center. So what's the best place for a workshop? And I don't even know when will time be when I actually have time for that. Alright, so we have a radio relay here. Income increased. And also decreasing the cost for the next area.
Welcome to the fight.
Awesome. 115 supplies now to income there. Now let's go to West Asia and make contacts. Because we need to...
Commander, we've utilized all of our available communications capacity. We can't establish any new contacts until we upgrade our systems.
Oh no. Not even this one? Oh hell. Okay, so there's the retaliation. Let's go set up the squad and then do this retaliation next time.
Setting course for the Arctic.
I'm flying back and forth, trying to make the contact, but never getting there. Healer. These missions are so fast that the healer is probably not useful, but combat-oriented specialist might be. We will take demo here as our grenadier. I probably want the Phantom Ranger here. So David, welcome back. Welcome back to the squad. Let's put you here in the front. Let me just make sure that you were. So soldier abilities, yes, you are a Phantom Ranger. And we will have one of each. Let's see if we take a more experienced sharpshooter. What do we have here? Sam is still wounded a bit. Overwatching sniper. Well, one of them. Let's give Marpo's hero goes. Marpo's hero can join the squad. Let's make sure I remembered correctly. I just said it. But let's make sure. So we have a lone watch. Yeah. I want that. So I can do overwatches. On the other hand, for retaliation, is it better to have a gunslinger with us? I don't have a gunslinger yet, do I? Ready to fight, that is. Yeah, I don't. Two grenadiers, not a bad idea. Let's see about the other grenades. So, actually, before I forget, even if we don't take a medic, you will take the med kit. Acid grenade. Shred more armor than standard frag grenade. Enemies burned by acid will take additional damage over multiple turns. Well, that sounds good. Gas grenade. Have a larger radius than a standard frag grenade. Poison gas has dramatic effects on organic enemies, slowing them and doing damage over time. Let's take the acid. Flashbang has proved useful. That would mean three frag grenades and one. No, let's take a frag grenade. We have the acid, we have the flashbang. I think those will be the ones we go with. So, yes, this is the squad, and I'll see you next time for the second retaliation, Operation Dawnclaw. Thanks for watching. Until next time, take care. Bye bye.